So we'll start with part number four now. Part number four that I will write here. Part number four is x minus 3. Then you have 2x plus 1, which is equal to x into x plus 5. You can just simplify this. X into 2x will be 2x square. X into 1, that will be x only. Then you have minus 3x into 2x. Minus 3 into 2x, that is minus 6x. Minus 3 into 1, that is minus 3. Which will be equal to x into x, that is x square. X into 5, that is 5x. Done. So you can just write a 2x square minus 5x minus 3 minus x square and then minus 5x, that is equal to 0, which implies 2x square minus x square is x square, minus 5x minus 5x is minus 10x, and then you have minus 3, which is 0, right? So we can write which is of the form. Which is of the form a x square plus bx plus c equals 0 with a not equal to 0. And that is coefficient of x square is not 0. So it's a quadratic equation. All right. So this is part number 4. Now part number 5. Let's come to the part number 5, that is. Part number 5 will be, written here. What's part number 5 is? 2x minus 1. Then you have x minus 3. That's equal to x plus 5 and x minus 1. So again, we will simplify it. 2x into x, that is 2x square. 2x into minus 3, that is minus 6x. Minus 1 into x is minus x. Minus 1 into minus 3 is positive 3. That's equal. xx, that's x square. X into negative 1, that's negative x. 5x, 5 into x. 5 into negative 1 is minus 1. Okay. You write 2x square. It is 7x plus 3. Shift this to this side, you get x square. This thing will be 4x. If you just check the moment you shift it to this side, you get negative 4x, and this will be positive 5 equal to 0. Right? So 2x square minus x square is x square. Minus 7x minus 4x is this much. 3. 5 is 8, 0, right? So, which is of the form? Ax square bx plus c equals 0. A is not equal to 0. So, fifth is a quadratic equation. So that was part number 5. Now we'll take up part number 6, 7 and 8, right? So let me rub it here. Let me rub it off, right? Fourth will rub around it. Sixth part we will write here, okay, and let me change color. Is it take it to the red? Sixth one is x square plus 3x plus 1 equal x minus 2 whole square. So this is x square plus 3x plus 1 equal, you can just use the formula x square plus 2 square minus 2 x and 2, right? So that is either x square plus 3x plus 1, which is x square plus 4 minus 4x. Okay, so you get x square plus 3x plus 1. Shift it, you get minus x square, you get minus 4, you get plus 4x. Okay, that is 0. Now x square and x square will go. 3x plus 4x is, you can just write 7x. 1, you'll get minus 3 equal to 0. So again, you will write which is not a quadratic. Okay. It is not a quadratic because there is no x square valid term with non-zero coefficient, right? So this is a, this is not a quadratic. In fact, this one is linear, right? So this is part number 6. Let's come to the part number 7 and 8 now. So part number 7 we will take here. Part number 7 is x plus 2 whole cube equal to x square minus 1. Okay, so you will use the formula a plus b ka whole cube, that's a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into x plus or a plus b, which is equal to, you can just multiply this, you will get 2x cube minus 2x. So further you can just simplify this, you will get x cube, you will get 2 8 cube plus 6x x plus 2 2x cube minus 2x, right? So you'll get x cube plus 8 plus 6x square plus 12x equal 2x cube minus 2x. Done. So you can just write this as x cube plus 8 plus 6x square plus 12x minus 2x cube plus 2x equal to 0. Now this implies x cube minus this, so you get minus x cube, then you have 6x square, we'll write this, 12x, 2x, that is 14x. 8, simple 8, that is 8 equal to 0, which is not a quadratic. What's the reason? As degree equals to 3, right? You know, for quadratic the degree must be 2, but the degree is 3, that means it's cubic, not quadratic. So that's part number 7. Okay, now let's take the last part of this question. And we'll check whether that is a quadratic or not. And let me change the color. Take it green. See, the last part, that's the eighth part. Eighth part is x cubed 4x square minus x plus 1 is equal to x minus 2 whole cube. Okay, so this implies x cube 4x square minus x plus 1 as it is. Now here we will use the formula a minus b the whole cube, that's x a cube minus b cube. Okay, then you will have minus 3 times a b into a minus b, right? So this will yield us x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1 as it is. This will be x cube, this will be minus 8, this will be minus 6x, x minus 2. Okay, now this is x cube minus 8 minus 6x square plus 12x, that is it. So we can now shift it. You can write x cube minus 4x square minus x plus 1. Shift this thing to this side, then minus x cube, then you'll get plus 8, then we'll plus 6x square, then you'll get minus 12x, that is 0. Now x cube and x cube will go. X cube minus x cube. Minus 4x square plus 6x square, you'll get 2x square. Minus x minus 12x, so you'll get minus 13x. 1 and a, that's 9. So that's equal to 0. So you can write which is of the form, which is of the form ax square bx plus c equal to 0 with a not equal to 0. So it's a quadratic. So it's a quadratic equation. That's part number 8. And in the next slide, we will take up the question number 2 of this exercise.